the signs of the intangible but definitive part of the existence, the signs of the intangible but definitive part of the existence is Dharma. Listen carefully. Signs of the intangible but definitive part of the existence is Dharma, and applied signs of the intangible but definitive existence is called Agama. I love you guys with my absolute love for all of you. I am revealing these signs. Understand one thing. First, drop the stupidity which you are taught by the atheists. Intangible does not exist. No. Intangible exists and it matters. One of the biggest stupidity the atheism taught to the world, brainwashed the whole world with the idea intangible does not exist. No. Actually, the intangible is 99% of your life. Tangible is only 1% of your life. That is why when you become atheist, life seems to be heavy on you. You don't have answer for anything. You don't have formula, principle, sutra, idea, understanding about anything. When you deny the existence of intangible, you destroy your very existence. Intangible but definitive components of your life, parts of your life, as a great science. Whether in your logic level, in your emotion level, in your functioning of the mind, functioning of your body, in every level, understand? Today's satsang is very intense, like panagam. If you are doing Pachapatni Vratam, you know the taste of the panagam by now. With the real ginger and lemon jaggery water. How it tastes deep your throat. The today's satsang is like a panagam. Here again and again, you will understand what I am saying. I'll give you a very simple example which you all understand very easily. The psychological sexual pleasure, intangible, but it is definitive part of all human beings. Like watching pornography or sexting. I am not saying it is right or wrong. I am not getting into that subject now. I am only saying all these are intangible but as definitive part in your inner space. This one small example, I can give you multiple. For example, if you are fasting, within 2-3 days, the dream you will be feasting. It may be intangible. Feasting in your dream, eating all varieties of food in your dream may be intangible, but it is definitive part of your existence. And if you continue to fast with a higher powerful cognition, that powerful cognition gets into your dream. Even in your dream, you will say, no, I don't want to eat because I am doing Pachapatni Vratam for Parashakti. Fasting is one of the easiest way of putting any powerful cognition into your innermost, deepest conscious part. Any powerful cognition is like a seed. If you put that seed in the deepest consciousness, core of your being, it will become reality just like that.